Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today at Apple's Worldwide Developer Conference, they gave us all sorts of information about the next versions of macOS X and iOS. So let's take a look. So the first thing they talked about was the next version of OS X for the Mac, and it's going to be called Yosemite, going along with the California place names titles. And this new version, of course, is going to have a bit of a makeover like all of them do. It's going to be new fonts, a cleaner look. They've cleaned up a lot of toolbars and made a lot of things translucent. Translucent toolbars and title bars and sidebars so they kind of reflect the colors beneath them. They talked a lot about some interesting features. For instance, there's going to be something called Markup in Mail, which allows you to attach images to mail messages and then mark them up right in Mail. You can add a little bit of text, arrows, you can crop them, things like that. So it makes it really easy to kind of edit an image and send it to someone. Also, they've revamped Spotlight. So the Spotlight menu at the upper right-hand corner of your screen now, you can do lots of cool things with. And you can still do all of that, it looks like, except that they moved it to the center of the screen. You click on the magnifying glass at the upper right-hand corner, and now it goes to the center, and there's even more things that you can do. Matter of fact, it reminds me a little bit of the functionality Siri can do. Not in the speech department, but in be able to look up information online and get things like that. So that's all going to be sort of front and center in the new version of macOS X. There's also talk about a lot of new cloud features, and one that a lot of people have been asking for is the ability to just store files in iCloud rather than having them to be documents of, say, Pages or Keynote, just have files. And it looks like we'll get that with something called iCloud Drive, which allows you to store any files and also access your documents as files rather than only inside the apps. And that'll go between Macs and iOS. There's also going to be AirDrop functionality between Macs and iOS, which will be nice. A lot of people want that. And something called MailDrop, which allows you, when you attach a large file to an email, that iCloud will handle the large file and take that file, and if somebody has a Mac or an iOS device on the other end, they'll get it as normal. But if somebody doesn't, if they're using another type of a mail server, then it will actually store the file in the cloud and allow them to download it. So it'll eliminate the problem when you attach something too big and the other person at the other side can't get it. And there was also a lot of talk about integration between apps on the Mac and an iOS, allowing you to go between devices. So for instance, you could start composing an email on your iPad and then pick up composing on your Mac rather seamlessly. A big feature in cooperation between Macs and iPhones is communication. And they've got a couple big features. One is that your iPhone can act as a conduit between your Mac with iMessages and somebody who's not using iMessages but using standard SMS. So somebody sends you an SMS message, now you get it just on your iPhone. You don't get it in Messages on your Mac. But in the future, you'll be able to get that through your iPhone and see it on your Mac in Messages, even though they're not using iMessage. And a kind of a big deal too is the ability for your Mac to receive and make phone calls through your iPhone. So your iPhone gets a phone call, it'll show up as a notification on your Mac, and you can actually use your Mac, your speaker and your microphone to take that call rather than having to use your iPhone. Now, of course, there was also a lot of talk about the next version of iOS, iOS 8 for iPhones and iPads. And the next version is going to have some pretty neat new features, but most of the talk today was about things that developers will be able to do with iOS 8. So there's going to be more features available for developers, more things they can do, more tools available to them to make better and better apps. But there was some talk of new features as well. Two new features that stood out for me. One was QuickType, which is predictive typing. So it's as you're typing on the iPhone and say you're typing a message, you'll see predictive words show up and you can just tap those rather than completing typing the entire word. And it's supposed to be context sensitive and even person sensitive, so it'll choose words depending upon who you're talking to and what type of conversation you're having. And another big new feature, something that's available in apps now, but they're going to integrate it into Messages, the ability to easily send and receive both audio and video messages while you're talking with somebody. So you could be texting with somebody and then decide instead of replying to them via a text message, you can simply hit a microphone button, talk, and then it will send them a piece of text. Or you could do the same thing with video. So you can kind of switch the conversation between texting, audio, and video all in the same conversation. Now for both Macs and for iOS, it looks like Apple wants us to move our photos more and more to the cloud. And there's a lot of talk about the iCloud photo library. There's going to be a lot more integration with that in iOS, and also not only in the new version of macOS 10, but there's going to be a new photo app for the Mac coming out next year that'll integrate more. And it sounds like Apple will allow us to basically keep our entire photo library online and access it easily from all the different devices, rather than having to worry about, well, the photos are on my Mac and I have to sync them with my iPhone or between different Macs and things like that. So there's going to be a lot of new features and functionality with these two new OSs, and also with a new app next year. Siri is also going to get an upgrade. There will be the ability to use Siri without having to touch the phone, so be able to use your voice to activate it, and also a streaming recognition. So Siri will actually recognize what you're saying while you're saying it, rather than having to complete your sentence and finish it and submit. Some other interesting things that developers will have is they'll have the ability to provide third-party keyboards, which should be interesting when those become available to see what developers come up with. There's also a lot of new tools for developers, including a completely new programming language that Apple has come up with called Swift that should allow developers to create apps even more efficiently. So that's a look at the two new operating systems, and both are available now for developers. So developers are able to get these, start testing their apps out and making new apps that link into the functionality of these new operating systems. This summer there's also going to be a special beta program for non-developers. So finally Apple's giving a chance for non-developers who really want to use the new operating system to use it before it's released. And then it'll be released for the general public in the fall. Both are going to be free updates, just like the previous versions of these operating systems. So you can look for that. And also, if you want more information, the complete video of today's keynote should be available by the time that you see this up at the Apple site.